So this is happening when your memory card is too small and the batteries are low. What I wanted to finish is I hope that that my digestive system will process this, but actually, and yeah, I can say I don't care what my digestive system thinks of that. I will eat it with joy. So by now it's a bit more time passed on, but I want to share something with you. So let's climb a bit. So Emily, here I did something for you this morning before I opened your parcel, and I read that you're in hospital again. I created a bit of a new altar for you, or should I say I incorporated you in my owl altar now, and you can see some of the reindeer antlers are here with the owls. This is some owl and reindeer magic which I hope will help you through the hopefully short time in hospital. So I can see here a dark barn owl and a light one, and mother and child protecting you. And here you can say, look at that, the other reindeer I cut out, the one I didn't choose for your book, the one with a smile on it, but not the really fine smile. But this smile, this smiling reindeer is perfect here for this one. So I have to put back the, it's so fragile, the broom I have here. And I also incorporated your feathers here. Yeah. And I have probably lit every candle here I have. Here also, here's the stone I will put on my Lady Tilia shrine later. Oh, but look at that. Here's something I forget. A bit of a belated Yule tree. This is still for me the time of Yule, and I will keep my Yule tree until, yeah, I think until nearly the end of January, I think. And as you can see, here's some fine, fine German weather here. Yesterday it rained like, I don't know, the whole day, and the raining area was, I think, as big as Germany itself. And now we're getting huge, huge winds, and guess what? Tomorrow we want to go hiking in the Deister Hills, which I found really and joyful to look forward to, because you can imagine how much fun it is to walk in storm and rain. But it's what should I say, a hiking with Henrik's flying colleagues from his hang glider club, and afterwards we will go to a restaurant and eat geese. I think I won't eat geese because I can't purchase egg. What? So bullshit. I can't process it with my digestive system because geese is quite fat, and I don't think my tummy will like it. Although I like geese very much, but not this time. I will choose something else. Look at that. And it's blowing, it's blowing, it's blowing. You can hear the wind howling. And yeah, it's a fine winter here in Germany. Lovely. The only snow you can see is this one here. Some fake snow. Oh, wow. The wind is really, look at that. You can't see the wind, the heavy winds in winter quite well, because no leaves on the trees. But when trees are moving like this, sometimes you can guess that there is some heavy winds going on, and the clouds are moving quite fast too. Oh, what a weather! But it's not the weather's fault, I should say. So don't look at my mess here, and particularly not in the kitchen. But I want to show you this now. Also, this is also, I light it also for you. The incense stick is already burnt down. I put this on. The Winter Mother, who protects the foxes. And here's my Clara, my crystal ball. Yeah, I still have no name for this little one here. This little Queenie Owl here. Maybe you have some suggestions for it. So, in here is another. It's the card of Yule. And the other ones here. And my lovely tree here. And I love this picture. Look at that. Isn't that peaceful? Lovely, lovely, lovely. I love it. Oh, and I can see now here your friendship's altar. Now in a bit better light conditions. And this one is quite new. I don't know if you can see it, because yeah, you can see it, the rainbowy stars here inside. I loved it. I purchased it in a, yeah, you would call it an esoteric bookstore here in Hanover, the only one esoteric bookstore we have. But they have really wonderful items and really wonderful candlesticks and incense sticks and all such things, and tarot cards and oracle decks, and oh, such lovely. And the smell is wonderful. It smells of incense when you're coming in. But I see now, the incense, no, the oil infuser is hot. Yeah, it is hot. I will put some Yule oil in it, 'cause it's still Yule for me. Oh, I forget. Look at this here. I will find a better place for it until I find out where. I will put it in on here. And here is some accompanies to this one. And here's my Yule father. Now is here in retirement for the year. And my lovely, you can't see it really good. It's too dark. I will look what I can do. You can see it. This is my talking stick, my talking piece for council when we have council in Egon's villa. Unfortunately, it doesn't it didn't have the time to do its wonders by now, but it will come. The time of this wonderful stick will come. So you can see this, and now don't look at the mess. So I'm really moving fast. Here is my Guan Yin altar, and I put a lovely prayer for Emily here underneath it. So look at her peaceful face. And look at that. If you can see it, no, you can't see it. I will try to make a bit more light here. Yeah, no, you can see it. Whoa, someone just put on the sun here. It's another calendar we got for Yule as a gift from a friend. It's a lovely, lovely picture calendar from Ireland, and it's from a member of a medieval band, is also, well, yeah, which is also on the MPS. I think on all the MPS is this band. This band is called Saltatio Mortis, and my friend is a big, big fan of Saltatio Mortis. And one of the band members is a quite fine photographer, and he made wonderful pictures. And I hope you can see. Oh, this is lovely. Here you have the days on the bottom and here on the top. Lovely. But I look for a special picture. Look at this. I look for a special picture because This will. Oh, look at this. When I look through the camera, it looks like I watch. I'm filming directly at the place. Look at this. Lovely. Oh, here. This, Emily Elijah, I think you will recognize, because it's a motif from Game of Thrones. The King Street, I don't know if you call it like this, but it is set on the back of the calendar that it is famous now because of Game of Thrones. And the photographer said that it was quite difficult to take a picture here because this street is quite full of people now because all of them want to see this magical street from Game of Thrones, and now you have it here, and this is so lovely. Lovely, lovely. I tried to figure out how it is called, so I will put it. Ah, I thought it was so. Let's see. The dark hedges. Yes, they say King's Path or King's Way or something like that. King Street from Game of Thrones. I actually didn't watch much of the episodes. It was a violent partly. I'm not the one anymore for series or TV shows or TV shows with many parts. I was a huge TV junkie when I was a teen and up to my 20s, but since I'm with Henrik, who is not a fan of television, and we nearly don't watch normal television anymore, except for documentary channels or something like that, I basically quit TV shows, and it's fine. Sometimes I have some on my computer and look and watch it, but the real life now is quite busy, and there's no need for much TV entertainment anymore, except for fine documentaries or fine films on DVD. Or look at that. What an amazing sunset. Wow. Oh, here. Look at that. Maybe I will come to some place like this one day. Oh, look at that. So mystical. Yeah, maybe one day. Don't lose hope. Ah, it's lovely. Look at this. Wow. So, I hope you're doing well, Emily Elijah. And by the time you will see this, I hope everything went well and you're fine and with us again. So, don't lose hope. We are all praying for you. And until the next time. So bye, Emily Elijah, and bye my sisters.